Hello everyone. Hope all of you are doing great. I'm also doing absolutely fine. Now, why am I here? I'm here to give you a strategy to achieve a rank. But for those as well who are having the last minute jitters, just listen to this next few minutes that I'm going to talk to you. Now, see, I've told you many times in all my classes that you're not students anymore. You are warriors. You are fighting against 500,000 like you, and all of them have their unique strategies. They have their own capabilities. So you also need to develop one. So the basic strategy that you want is like this. Firstly, attend your classes. Come for the live class. Come as much as possible for the live class. It helps you in two ways. First, there is real-time doubt solving. And secondly, it also motivates the teacher to perform better. So now, not talking about the teacher, but for you now. So secondly, what you need to do, secondly, complete your exam kits. So sir, which exam kits to take? Now my suggestion is take any and do the extra questions from the other one. So don't do the repeated question, do the extra questions. Exam kit is nothing but the past year questions that have been asked. Point number three, you need to train your brain. It's not a test of your knowledge. Yes, welcome to ACCA skill level. It's a test of your skills. So you need to train your brain for what? To appear in that examination for that 3 hours. So train your brain. How do you train your brain? Past 10 year papers, 3 hours in that limited time frame. Try and attempt, no matter how many marks you score. No one's giving you anything or taking away anything. You fail, pass, doesn't matter. But your mind has to be trained to sit for 3 hours and do its best. So that's how you train your brain. Then appear for mocks, right? And get them evaluated by a professional who's most probably an ACCA professional. Then see, before the exam, right? 1 week before the exam, have short notes ready. So how that will help is that you can just go through those notes again and again. So you can just probably, you might write some mnemonics in the audit, right? So you can write some mnemonics which you think you might want to remember at the time of your exam, right? So those are the few things from my side. And always remember, those 3 hours matter. It does not matter what you did before or what you're going to do after that. But those 3 hours are going to matter as far as your exam is concerned. Also, one very important thing is the examiner's guidance. So for every past year paper, you'll have an examiner's guidance. So go through it, read it, see what mistakes others have made and learn from those mistakes. So that's it from my side here. Thank you so much. I'll see you next time around. Till then, take care. Bye bye. Namaskar. Thank you.